Up next, Boyd Huppert. The broadcasting spark started for Boyd Huppert in high school when he worked for a rural Wisconsin radio station. His career in television began in 1984, and KARE 11 has served as Boyd's home for nearly 30 years. Boyd created the franchise, many of you I'm sure are familiar with it, most of you probably, Land of 10,000 Stories. He's a sought-after speaker and presenter and is regarded as the best local storyteller in the country. Numerous Emmy, National and Regional Murrows, Scripps Howard Award, and Silver Circle highlight just a few recognitions.
When the anchor reads the tease for a Boyd Huppert story, the audience knows what to expect. They know Boyd better than their next door neighbor.
If we're going to do a story,
opening day 2013,
they consider him much more than a TV reporter.
Listen.
For Boyd, specializes in stories that reach far beyond the headlines.
He's kind, he's intelligent, he really cares about all of his coworkers and wants them to do the best work that they can.
He couldn't be any more like of a humble person and any more of just a delight to be around.
One of the best things someone could call you as a photographer, as a storyteller. He used to say, hey, Gary, storyteller. Well, that's the ultimate. You know, to be called a storyteller, it doesn't get any better than that.
It was here, Greg Thomas, crumbling himself.
It's the highlight of my career.
Came to pray.
Working with him, he brings so much energy, so much passion, so much respect.
I spoiled her. That's what she always told me.
He's a very talented, very thoughtful reporter, and he's always thinking about who these people are and what it means to them.
No one can stop me!
Boyd is kind, and he's a good guy, and he's friendly, but the guy has high expectations.
I've never considered it to be terribly hard work. What my dad did on the dairy farm, that's hard work.
His work ethic is bar none.
He's spreading that message of great storytelling to journalists all over the country.
The power of our language.
And the fruits are shown for themselves, and that's the farm kid. And that's what they do. They produce from the ground up and make it plentiful for all.
You can go to any city, any state, at this point, any country, and find someone that was inspired by Boyd or that has learned from Boyd, even if it's just one story.
I would not be in this industry if it weren't for Boyd Huppert.
He joined the team as a general assignment reporter and for years shared a lot of bad news.
Some of the residents could see the flames from blocks away
and found himself gravitating in the opposite direction.
I think it's part of balance. There's good versus evil. And I think if we're going to cover the ills in our community, then we also have a responsibility to cover the good.
Your passion for local journalism is an inspiration for all of us. I want to thank you for the stories you continue to tell and for setting the standard for the next generation of journalists.
I think that he has touched so many lives, and that is what this is all about. What he has achieved has little to do with the actual stories, which are so impressive, and more to do with all those people that he has touched over all these years.
What a gift. Please welcome to the stage 2023 Minnesota Broadcasters Hall of Fame inductee, Boyd Huppert.
Thank you, Dan. You are a treasure. I've never had an opportunity to tell you that to your face. Appointment viewing for me every day when I'm near a radio at 3 o'clock. Thank you to the committee that selected me to be here tonight. Congratulations, Lee, Tim, Jim, and Mary. It's an honor for me to be in your class. I stopped a while back to visit some old friends. Some old friends at the Pavick Museum, hanging on a wall. I saw Roger Awesome. I saw John Gallis and Mary Davies. I knew them as a child as Clancy the Cop, Carmen the Nurse, and Casey Jones. And they were my companions every day, every morning, every lunchtime, and every afternoon. I saw Boone and Erickson, Roger and Charlie. Jim, we had them on in our dairy barn too, and they kept us laughing. Good morning, good morning. How many of you remember? It's grand to be on hand. Come on. Good morning to you. There's no better way to start a morning. I saw Howard Viken and Steve Cannon, who rode with me on the tractor more times than I care to remember. And Dave Moore, who tucked us into bed every night with the 10 o'clock newscast on WCCO. As I think about that visit to see my old friends, it leaves me with one question. How did I get so lucky? So lucky to be going up on that wall with my old friends. And I think it really goes back to, how did I get so lucky to be born into my family? With a dairy farmer for a dad with an unbelievable work ethic, just a little of which rubbed off on me, with a mom who taught me that the most important F word wasn't farming. There were a couple more. She's worried right now. Faith and family. My mom is here tonight, and I am so glad that you can be here tonight. How did I get so lucky to have siblings like Blaine and Leanne, who are here tonight, and Jay and Jill? We had so much fun growing up together on that farm. And the crazy thing is, when we get together, we still do. How did I get so lucky to have managers like Rita Butero, my executive producer, and Jeremiah, who's here someplace helping run the show tonight, Jeremiah Jacobson, there he is. You've given me room to run and supported me even when I stumbled. How did I get so lucky to have photographers like Chad Nelson and Rob Collett, who are here tonight? You have made me better than I am and provided me with incredible companionship along the way. You are my best friends. And I also want to acknowledge your wives. Brianna couldn't be here tonight, so I'm going to talk to Cassie. Cassie, thank you for letting Chad come out and play with me. Even when you knew I probably wouldn't have him home in time for dinner and often bedtime. You're a big part of this too. How did I get so lucky to have coworkers like Dana Theed and Mark Daly? Coworkers who became dear friends. People I look forward to seeing every day. In Dana's case, in the newsroom. In Mark's case, twice a week, three times a week, in the racquetball court. And Rena. Let me tell you about Rena Sargentopoulos. When I was in the thick of my cancer battle 18 months ago, too sick and too tired to get out of bed, my wife came in and said, I think you should come outside. And outside my driveway were 40 of my KARE coworkers with balloons and banners and a cake and presents, because they didn't think that we should be alone on my 60th birthday. And Rena was behind all of that. You are the kindest person that I know. Rivaled closely by my neighbors, John and Kristen, who were there with support including a running snowblower, whenever I needed help. And Marcia, my neighbor across the street, I'm lucky I live on a corner lot, so I have neighbors across the street in both directions. Marcia, who supplied me with gallons of matzo ball soup when I was ailing. She called it the Jewish penicillin. And I think you're right, because I'm here. Finally, how did I get so lucky to have sons like Sam and Matt? You were accursed with a father who worked in television news nightside, which meant way too many missed tuck-ins and high school concerts and hockey and baseball games. Yet somehow you persevered and turned into young men that any father, especially this father, can be proud of. And Sherry, we met at 17 years old at the Pierce County Fair. You have been with me every step of the way in my broadcasting career, from radio in River Falls to television stations in Wausau and Omaha and Milwaukee, and finally at KARE 11. And next spring, we will celebrate our 40th wedding anniversary. In broadcast years, I think that's 80 years. I honestly don't know how you did it. If there were a Broadcast Spouse Hall of Fame, you'd already be in it. All of you played a role in me standing up here tonight. In a perfect world, you'd be all hanging up on that wall with me. That would make me happy. Because any of you who know me know that I am happiest when I'm in the company of my family and surrounded by my friends. Thank you.